Hi, I'm Terry Hitchcock, and you're watching Harkins Theatres Behind the Screens, and we are talking about the sci-fi adventure Voyagers today, starring Lily Rose Depp and Ty Sheridan, who play two young adults bred for their intelligence, raised without any outside influences, so they don't know what they're missing when they leave Earth for an 80-plus year journey to colonize a distant planet. A crucial discovery mid-flight changes everything. Behind the Screens had a chance to Zoom with the cast and director Neil Berger.
This is our best chance to find a habitable planet.
You know, your characters have no choice here. They are forced basically to go on this trip. If you had a choice, are you going?
Am I going today? I don't know. I don't know. I want to say probably not, because I feel like I have a lot that I'm leaving, that I'd be leaving behind. And I feel like, you know, as I get older, if I have children and stuff, like, I feel like there's a lot that I like about my life here on Earth. But at the same time, like, who knows, you know, you never say never, and who knows what developments will happen. You know, but for now, I want to say maybe not. I'd rather maybe watch a movie about it.
Ty, you going if you had a choice?
You know, if it wasn't a definite one-way ticket, maybe. But I think in the case of the film, in the context of the film, these characters are on a mission to reach this very distant planet. It's going to take them 86 years to get to, they're trying to colonize. I don't know if I would board that train. I'm interested in going to space, you know, going to some other planet maybe, but right. I don't know if I'm going to do the 90-year trip.
Yeah, I think I'm going to pass. Plus, you didn't even get a travel brochure to get to see where you were even going.
Exactly.
You don't even know.
Where
you don't know what's happening over there.
Well, Christopher found a hidden compartment in the ship's plans.
Oh, it's such an interesting concept. You're given the necessities. There's nothing extraneous here for you all as you grow up on this flight. So Lily Rose, if you could bring something totally extraneous and not that important, but would help you sustain years on this thing, what are you bringing?
Wow. I guess if there was no kind of concern about like the weight of the items, I guess I would just bring like as many books as I could carry, just to like keep myself entertained and keep my mind like nourished. I would say like a TV and a bunch of movies, but I don't know about the connection, like things like that. I'd rather just stick to books. I would bring as many books as I could carry, you know, yeah.
I'd bring a map.
A Mac?
A map.
Oh, a map.
You know, you could pull up a map on your Mac, you know.
Yeah.
Well, I think I would bring a drawing pad, because everything else is so digital and, right, you know, and it's all screen-based, that to somehow kind of just, you know, get into something that's more tactile and would be great.
Good question. Probably a laptop. Is that boring?
Okay. Yeah.
Or actually, no, you know what? Maybe a plant. No. A final answer, a dog.
Oh, that, you know what? That's the best answer. That's the best answer so far, by far.
What else are they telling us?
The other fascinating thing is they don't know what they don't know. So there's not really much to miss, because they don't know what they're missing. They don't have any pop culture reference. What is a movie, an outside influence that really has influenced you as a person? What is that film for you?
That has really influenced me as a person. Wow. I mean, there's so many, like, it's really hard to pinpoint one that has really changed my life. But I would have to say, and this is very, it's a very kind of like fantastical movie. And so it's not like directly something that I've like tried to live my life by, but I've been very influenced by Poudin, which is this like French movie with Catherine Deneuve, which is like an incredible, incredible movie. And I guess it's just it's influenced me a lot in my curious nature and in my kind of like love of all things mystical and magical. I don't know. I can't say that I can pinpoint a movie that's like changed the way that I behave and interact with people. I would say that's more down to maybe like the people that are in my life that have influenced me the most. But I guess, that's a movie that's definitely influenced like maybe just like my personality or like the way that I the things that I like.
If I can think of a specific movie, but I think it's movies like this, you know, that question our morality, that question our true nature, you know, that I think in retrospect, you know, as the audience, get you asking questions about yourself.
Mm-hmm, yeah.
Because that's why stories are powerful. You know, stories are powerful because they can teach us lessons and make us, you know, think about things that we typically wouldn't be thinking about if it weren't for that story. So I think to me, that's the power of storytelling, and that's the power of films and filmmaking. So I think this film is definitely one of those films, which is exciting.
There's a toxin in the water.
It's coming from us. We're eating something toxic.
It's the blue.
I guess one of the messages here is, listen, if somebody gives you a drink that is 100% blue, be cautious. What is your drink of choice? What is your favorite drink?
Well, I'm kind of a beer person. On the other hand, though, I've become very attached lately to, during confinement, to a Negroni.
Oh, interesting. Yeah,
I know.
A drink of choice. Probably there's, you can get this apple juice over here. I don't know if you can get it, if the brand is there. It's called Capella, and there's apple and elderflower. Apple and elderflower juice, and it is delicious.
I am writing this down. I just got a good tip from you. I'm writing this down because I'm absolutely going to try to track that thing down.
We can do what we want.
Yeah! You know, it's fascinating to watch some of the fight scenes in this because they have no reference. I mean, they don't have the WWE.
They don't know how to fight. Yeah.
They don't know how to fight. So how was it choreographing fights where you're not supposed to have a reference to any of this?
Well, I was really interested in that. I mean, that was, you know, to come up with a fighting style for people that have never seen a fight. And I actually studied, you know, chimpanzees and other apes and monkeys fighting in the wild and how they did it. You know, they're not doing it in a normal kind of, they're not setting up, they're just swinging their weapon that they have attached to them, which is their arm and their forearm, in kind of a wild way. And you can see them in the movie fighting in a very similar way. It's like, what can I use to hurt the other person? You know, I can kick them or I can swing my arm, but they're not throwing punches. Actually, Ty Sheridan throws a punch later, but that's because he's seen some other films by them.
I put this on. Why? You're coming with me.
You mentioned Ty. He's good in everything he does. I'm starting to become more familiar with Lily Rose, and obviously you've got so many great close-ups of her, and it's hard not to see a little bit of her dad or her stunning mother in her face. What impressed you the most about her?
I think just her, I mean, a couple of things. She has like a really wonderful calm about her when she's on screen, and she just, or a stillness to her where you just kind of read everything emotionally inside her through her eyes. And then on a personal level, she's just the most down to earth and nice person and hardworking and giving. And so it was a great combination, and I think it's going to be a real discovery for people who are going to be knocked out by her performance, because what does she, you know, she gives such a great performance and she really holds the screen. I mean, she's a star.
I'm scared.
There's nothing to be scared of.
Yeah, I don't know what I'd take to kill 80 plus years on a spaceship. If I thought it would work, I'd take a Harkins loyalty cup, available at any Harkins theater. Hey, don't forget to like us on Facebook, Harkins Theaters, for your movie news, promotions, and giveaways, and we'll see you at the movies.